Hey guys, in this video we'll see how to use Dart on AWS Lambda. Dart runtime was announced for AWS Lambda around last year, and in this article, basically the AWS team, with the help of custom AWS Lambda runtimes, they say that we can implement a runtime in any programming language. This custom Lambda runtime basically defines HTTP-based specifications, and they clearly mention using these custom runtimes, we can also run Dart on Lambdas. AWS team also released a package called as AWS Lambda Dart Runtime on PubDev. And basically, this is the official Dart runtime for AWS Lambdas. This package shows us different ways in which Dart can be run on AWS Lambda. So let's see. There are two ways of running Dart on Lambdas. So first one is using serverless framework, and the second one is using the custom deployment. We will go ahead with serverless framework to deploy Dart-based Lambda functions. Make sure you have an AWS account and AWS CLI configured on your machine. In case you don't have the AWS CLI installed, so please refer the AWS command line interface article for installing it on respective operating systems. Coming back to our editor, we need to make sure that we have a framework serverless installed. So we do this check by running the command, and we get that, hey, we have successfully installed serverless. Basically, serverless is used to deploy the Lambda functions on AWS, and it takes care of all the managing of policies, provisioning of resources, etc. For installing serverless, there are different ways to do so depending on the operating system. So we used the npm way to install serverless. Our next step is to install serverless-dart, which is basically a serverless plugin for Dart language. So we'll install this serverless-dart plugin. This is the Git repository for serverless-dart. So inside this, it explains the different commands. Serverless-dart requires Docker to be installed, since it builds the function using a Docker image. So in short, we also need to install Docker on our machine. We'll use this command to create a serverless.application. You can replace the name hello with anything what you want. This is the structure of our Dart application after running that command. So let's see these files now. We changed some of the files. So let's start with pubspec.yaml. Inside this, we see two dependencies. The first one is aws.runtime, which is the official Dart runtime given by AWS. And other one is a dev dependency of buildrunner. Next file we'll see is serverless.yaml, but this is basically the brain behind this application. The service name is called hello. The provider is AWS, since serverless supports different providers. Runtime is Dart, of course, and memory size is specified as 128 megabytes. Inside the functions, we say the number of endpoints we want to expose. The first point is called hello. Inside it, the path is slash hello, and the method is of type get. And the handler which this hello is calling is main.hello. Let's see our main.dart now. Our main.dart comprises of runtime, which is basically a singleton. So this runtime we can use to register different handlers, and each handler is of type AWS API gateway event. This register handler function takes in a name and a handler parameter. So the name is main.hello, which if we notice in our serverless.yaml, it's the same main.hello. Let's see our handler definition now, which is Hello API Gateway, and just defined above. This comprises of two parameters, a context and an event. This context comprises of Lambda's execution information and comprises of various parameters like region or execution environment or session token, etc. The event, which is basically of type AWS API Gateway event, is extraction for the event class. And this event class comprises or can be of different types like Cognito event or S3 event. So in our case, we use the AWS API Gateway event. We create a response map by extracting the parameters from context as well as some parameters from event. Finally, this all is bundled as an AWS API Gateway response, which is the response returned by the gateway to the client. We encode the above response map and set it to the body of gateway response. Next, we set the base encoded to false, status code to OK, and finally, the headers are set to be JSON, and the response is returned back. For deploying the Lambda function, we first create a makefile. We create two commands, deploy and remove. If we run deploy, it will internally direct to npx serverless deploy, and for remove, npx serverless remove. Now let's run this make deploy command, and just make a note that before running this command, you need to make sure the Docker desktop is running. Once the command is executed successfully, we can see the endpoints being deployed and what are the region in which it was deployed, the service name, and the stage. Let's hit this endpoint now. So we copy the URL and paste on our browser, and we get the response as message hello, host, user agent. To verify, just for the safe side, we navigate to the S3 service of AWS and we see our bucket hello dev. And also, if we go to the CloudWatch logs, we can see hello dev hello. And if the log inside this log stream, we can see there was a request received. We enter a new entry inside the serverless YAML, and it's called as post request. The handler is also named as main.postRequest, and the endpoint is named as /postRequest. We create a separate folder called as post request. Inside the post request, we define the request model, means the body of our post request, which is expecting only name. We define the response from this post request, and the response comprises of a parameter message. Inside the post API gateway, we accept the request body from the request, we extract its name, and finally form the response body. The final response from this post API gateway is of type AWS API gateway response. We set the body parameter of response body and convert to string and set the status code to OK, and finally headers as application JSON. Back inside our main.dart, we register the handler for this post API and we put the name as main.postRequest, which is the same in the serverless YAML here. And for the handler part, we set up the post API gateway, which is nothing but the same API gateway which we defined earlier. Let's deploy the Lambda again. We can see here our both get and post endpoints are deployed now. So now let's test it. We use curl to test our post endpoint and pass in the body as name parameter with Asim. So the response is hello Asim from AWS Lambda, which is the same we have inserted in our response model. Back inside our AWS services, if we go in CloudWatch, inside our Lambda, and if we refresh, we should see the log watch. And if we click on this, we can see the requests for our post endpoint.
That's it from this video, guys. Source code and article links are mentioned in the description below. And thanks, guys, for watching.